These are the rooms of the Louis, especially Louis the 14th, who was king for 50 years.
Ladies and gentlemen, we would like to inform you that the museum will be closing in 15 minutes.
Señores y señores, el museo está cerrado. Tenga la amabilidad de dirigirse a la salida.
He was known as the Sun King, Loi Soleil. When he was young, he lived here in the Louvre. But eventually, he built himself an entirely new palace complex at Versailles. These are the figures of Socrates and Aspasia. Ancient Greek history. The use of ancient mythological motifs was very pronounced during the royal period. It gave an aura of ancient legitimacy and power to the kings. Into another room. These rooms have been recently refurbished. In the various styles of the Louis 14, 15, and 16. And they give one an idea of how it would be to live in the palace with the king. I must admit, I have no idea what it was like. Today, we have people walking through and looking at everything, admiring, but no one is afraid. It must have been quite different back in the day, when, if you were a noble and condemned to die, you only had your head cut off. But if you were a commoner, you would be half hung and then cut open, your bowels ripped out, and then perhaps cut into pieces or pulled apart by horses. In a salon like this, the gentle people would sit and talk. Perhaps a lady might catch up with her letter writing. This is the kind of palace we build nowadays. The Louvre is very old, but it also has this very new feature, the grand entrance. In the midst of all the wings of the palaces, this pyramid Over there is the entrance to the food court, where I had a sandwich and chips and iced tea for $15. This is a postmodern art exhibit. Neon lighting up the pyramid for a few months. And this is the last few minutes of the museum. Everyone is leaving. If you wish, you may climb the great spiral staircase. All this space is underground. The roof disabled elevator. a round structure that goes up to the exit level. You can perhaps see the traffic passing outside. It goes all the way down to the bottom level. This again is the art structure, dividing into four. And there, high over Paris, is the one and only moon. See, the disabled elevator has descended, revealing the center of the spiral staircase. Last visitors are leaving. It is almost 9 o'clock. I'm hoping to see, here it comes, the rising up of the disabled access elevator. Et voilà, mesdames et messieurs. Nous sommes ici, ladies and gentlemen, we are here. This is the first evening hour I have come here.
Can I take your camera again?
It is open until 8:45 on Wednesday and Friday nights.
You know, your older brother knows nothing about...
Merci. No. Gracias. The cafe Marley. What I find attractive, now that the fountains are turned off, the water is still and it reflects the palace and the evening crowds. Oh look, there's one of the little pyramids. And the walkway where people pass. Beyond that wing, beyond the pyramid, like three more wings of the palace, forming a great square. It was in that area that the original castle was built, and then torn down, the palace began to be built in the 14th and 1500s. And then gradually, it was extended through the centuries, 1500s, 1600s, 1700s, 1800s, until the two great wings reach out past that arch that Napoleon built. There used to be a palace connecting the ends of the two wings, called the Tuileries, but it was burned down in the rebellion of the Commune in the 1870s. Every day to sell their little Eiffel Towers. From the edge of the Louvre, through the trees, you can see the Eiffel Tower. And of course, the arch of the carousel, right in the middle of the palace grounds. In another week or two, I'll be going to the tower. I have two tickets, one to go to the second stage, which you can see there, just coming out of the trees, and another to go to very summit itself. The tower has been lit in this manner for a few years. I believe it's every 15 minutes or so, it lights up.